The R1 is compatible with our latest software, which is called Remotebox. It basically turns your iOS device into a wireless controller for the R1. So you can control most of the controls on here completely wirelessly from the iPad or your iPhone. So you can download it from the App Store for free. Once you've downloaded it, just connect to the built-in Wi-Fi on the R1. If you go into your Wi-Fi settings, to find out the Wi-Fi network's name, hold down Utility and then select WLAN Info. SSID is the name, so we've got XDJ-R1204. Hit back, scroll down, and then password. That'll tell you the password there, obviously. So just use that to connect on the iPad. Once you've connected, open Remotebox. The WLAN light will show up to say it's connected. And then you'll see the home screen of Remotebox. You've got the R1 split into sections, a help screen with a quick start guide and license agreement, as well as a settings section that we'll get to in a moment. If we start by going into USB browse, here you can browse everything obviously on the USB. You can see the different categories here and then the list just here. We can go through those, find the track we want. Then when we click on a track, we've got three options here. So we've got load one and load two, which obviously means to load a deck one or deck two. And then we've got the tag list. If we hit that, it will add that track to a playlist, which we can use essentially as a live playlist, so we can queue up tracks we want to play next or throughout the night. As well as that tag list, obviously we can see all of our playlists. We can create playlists from Remotebox and we can edit them. So if I click on a playlist, I can hit edit and I can delete tracks, or I can hit the plus button here and add more tracks. The tick appears to say it's going to be added, then hit done, and it's now in the playlist. Hit done to finish editing that playlist as well, and it'll update. So if we go back to our track, we can also hit info, and then we've got more information on the track. So if I load it to deck one, it's going to start playing automatically. If I hit deck one, you can now see the deck screen. We've got deck one, deck two, and a small mixer section in the middle. We've got the track information at the top, the BPM information and the tempo control, the pitch is written there. We've got this scrub bar. You can touch and drag to get to any point within the track, kind of similar to the needle search in the CDJ-2000 Nexus. We've got play, pause and cue buttons, and the plus and minus here are for really fine pitch adjustment. So it's just 0.02 of a percent, just because it's a lot more accurate than using the touchscreen. The hot cue and sampler section works exactly like it would on the hardware. We've got a couple of videos covering both of those if you want to check those out. And then a unique feature to Remotebox is the loop cutter. It's basically the auto beat loop, it's on the R1, only you can jump to any different beat division instantly, so you haven't got to scroll through per timing. So we can hit one to be in a one beat loop, jump to an eighth, 16 beat, half beat loop, then touch it again to turn it off. So that's the deck section there. We can then go into the effects section, and there's obviously one per deck as well. And on the R1, we've obviously got the beat effects here and the sound color effects. So what we can do is select a sound color effect and then a beat effect. And then we can use this touchpad to activate both effects at once to create really interesting different effects. So we can scroll left and right to change the beat timing. So that's the echo. And then we've got up and down to change the sound color. So we can adjust the filter like that. So we can filter an echo. We've got this hold button. If you hit the hold, then touch the pad, it'll keep that effect held there. So if you want to use one of the EQs or something on another deck, you can use that to keep the effect active. We've got a level depth, basically the overall wet and dry of the effects. And then we've got a tap button here to change the BPM of the beat effects. You can tap it to tap in your own effect, BPM, or you can hold it down to go to the automatic BPM, which is on the track. So the effects XY pad is unique again to Remotebox. It's something that you can't get on the hardware, obviously. So that's that section there. Next, we've got the mixer. As you can see on the deck and effects page, you've got the EQ controls, trim and the faders. If we hit mixer, you've then got all of the mixer controls. So you've got the headphones, faders, EQs, and then levels and auxiliary and microphone as well. So all of these controls, just touch and drag exactly as you would imagine. The EQ controls as well, if you double tap them, it will snap back to 12 o'clock. So if you bring the bass out of a track, you can double click and it cuts it straight back in. If you're using an iPhone, the mixer section is split into three different parts because obviously it's a smaller screen. You've got a fader section, you've got the isolate section, and then the in-out, which is basically the headphone controls, the master, the booth, and the aux and mic controls as well. So the final part of Remotebox is these settings, and these are just a basic list of settings to control the way Remotebox interacts with the R1. Load lock and needle lock will prevent you from loading a track or scrubbing through a track while it's playing. The platter will still work, however the scrub bar on the deck screen won't work when needle lock's on. You've got link with XDJ-R1 basically turns off the automatic linking. Adjustment of acceleration is the sensitivity of the faders and the EQ controls. And initialized setting data just sets all the settings back to default. Software takeover, it's kind of like a safety net. Remotebox and the R1's controls are obviously both independent. So you could have a control on Remotebox, for example, the mixer, the fader could be at the very bottom, whereas on the R1, it's still at the top. So with software takeover on, if I was to jog that, just to prevent that from snapping back to full volume, I have to bring this fader to the position of that fader there before it would take over control. So now it's working, but obviously until I get to that halfway point where the fader is in my Remotebox, this will have no effect. And then with software takeover off, I'll do the same thing again. If I bring the fader halfway down, the second I touch the fader on the hardware, the Remotebox fader is gonna follow that position. It's basically software takeover, to summarize, is kind of which is in control. If it's on, it's Remotebox. If it's off, it's the R1 hardware. So as you can see, Remotebox does extend the features of the R1. It's not essential. You don't have to have Remotebox to use the R1, but it does massively increase its capabilities.